Today we are going to discuss the procedure for limit test for heavy metals. Okay, so let us first see the principle involved in the limit test for heavy metals. The example of heavy metal impurity that may be present in the sample includes lead, mercury, bismuth, arsenic, antimony, tin, cadmium, silver, copper, molybdenum, etc. So the principle involved in this heavy metal limit test is brown color obtained by the reaction of heavy metal impurities with the saturated solution of hydrogen sulfide is compared with the standard color obtained by the reaction of known quantity of lead with hydrogen sulfide solution. Precipitate of heavy metal sulfide which is formed gives the brown color. Since this type of reaction takes place, that heavy metal cation reacts with hydrogen sulfide to form the metal sulfide which forms the brown precipitate, and so the solution gives brown color. Okay, so divalent metal cation or monovalent metal cation, it will react with hydrogen sulfide to form metal sulfide. For example, silver cation reacts with hydrogen sulfide to form silver sulfide, or lead cation reacts with hydrogen sulfide to form lead sulfide, which shows brown color. The reagents required to perform this test include hydrogen sulfide solution, which is a saturated H2S solution and it should be freshly prepared. Another reagent required is dilute acetic acid. It is prepared by diluting 5.7 ml of glacial acetic acid to 100 ml with water. Another important reagent is ammonia solution. It is prepared by diluting 425 ml of strong ammonia solution to 1000 ml with water. Dilute acetic acid and ammonia solution, they are used to maintain the pH between 3 and 4 so that precipitate form is colloidal and uniform. Another reagent required is lead standard solution containing 0.1% lead. It is prepared in this way: dissolve 0.4 gram of lead nitrate in water containing 2 ml of nitric acid and dilute to 250 ml with water, and then prepare lead standard solution 20 ppm lead by diluting 1 volume of lead standard solution containing 1000 ppm of lead to 50 volumes with water. Now let us see the procedure as per Indian Pharmacopoeia. Indian Pharmacopoeia provides three methods depending on the resulting solution of the substance. Means it depends upon the sample which method is used. Method A as per Indian Pharmacopoeia is used for the substances which gives clear colorless solution under specified conditions. So the procedure involved in this method A is: in two Nessler cylinders, label test solution and standard solution. Okay. So in Nessler cylinder labeled as test solution, transfer 25 ml of sample solution which is prepared as directed in the monograph. And in Nessler cylinder labeled as standard solution, transfer 1 ml of standard lead solution containing 20 ppm of lead and dilute to 25 ml with water. Now in both the Nessler cylinder, adjust the pH between 3 and 4 using dilute acetic acid or dilute ammonia solution. Then dilute both the solutions to 35 ml with distilled water and mix well. Then to both test solution and standard solution, add 10 ml of freshly prepared hydrogen sulfide solution and mix well. Then dilute both the solutions to 50 ml with water and allow to stand for 5 minutes and view downwards over a white surface. Another method described as per IP, that is method B, is used for the substances which does not give a clear colorless solution. So for such substances, the procedure is quite different. Okay. In standard solution, in Nestler cylinder labeled as standard solution, transfer 1 ml of standard lead solution containing 20 ppm of lead and dilute to 25 ml with water. For test solution, first transfer the prescribed quantity of sample into a crucible. Moisten the sample with sulfuric acid and ignite at a low temperature until thoroughly charred. Then to this sample add 2 ml of nitric acid and 5 drops of sulfuric acid and heat cautiously until white fumes are no longer evolved, preferably at 500 to 600 degrees Celsius, and cool it. To this mixture then add 4 ml of dilute hydrochloric acid and digest for 2 minutes and evaporate to dryness. Then add 10 ml of water and digest for 2 minutes. Then to this mixture add ammonia solution dropwise until the solution is just alkaline to litmus and dilute this solution to 25 ml with water. Now the remaining process is same for test solution and standard solution. For test solution, adjust the pH between 3 and 4 using dilute acetic acid. Similarly, adjust the pH between 3 and 4 for standard solution also. Then transfer the filtrate into Nestler cylinder for sample solution and dilute to 35 ml with water. Similarly, dilute the solution of standard solution to 35 ml with distilled water and mix well. Then to both the solutions add 10 ml of freshly prepared hydrogen sulfide solution and dilute to 50 ml with water. Now allow to stand for 5 minutes and view downwards over a white surface. Now one more method is there for limit test for heavy metal, that is method C. It is used for the substances which gives a clear colorless solution in sodium hydroxide medium. And this is the procedure. Take two Nestler cylinder and label them as test solution and standard solution. In Nestler cylinder labeled as test solution, dissolve the specified quantity of substance in a mixture of 20 ml water and 5 ml of dilute sodium hydroxide solution. While in the Nestler cylinder labeled as standard solution, transfer 1 ml of standard lead solution containing 20 ppm lead in Nestler cylinder and add 5 ml of dilute sodium hydroxide solution. Now make up both the solutions to 50 ml with water and mix. Add 5 drops of sodium sulfide solution to both test solution and standard solution. Mix well and allow to stand for 5 minutes and then view downwards over a white surface. Now if the observation is such that if the brown color produced in sample solution is less intense than that of standard solution, then the sample passes the limit test for heavy metals. Okay. So brown color in test solution is less intense than standard solution, then the sample passes the limit test for heavy metals. Now these are the references for the procedure for limit test for heavy metals. Thank you.